about me. As they mentioned earlier, I'm a junior at Mitchell High School. I started my campaign when I was 15. I'm 16 now, though. So just like you, I still go to school. I actually gave a big presentation today. Tonight, I'm going to give another one. I'm very, very too tired. I kind of kept the presentation a little bit short because I know as a student, we see presentations from our teachers all the time. So I totally get it. Other than, no you don't, you will soon when you get to high school.
Oh, Lord.
I know
that. Oh my god!
So other than doing activism, I'm a huge music lover. And I'll delve a little bit into why it's super important to everyone. So, yeah. So just like photos of me. This was actually the day of the walkout at my school with now State Senator Haskell, but he was running at the time. And then also accepting awards in New York with some fellow activists. Okay, so I kind of boil it down to three main rules for starting activism out, aka things I wish people told me. So the first one is know who you are. And what I mean by that is when you get involved in anything that you love, it's really important to know your reasons why you're doing it and why it's important to understand that in anything you do in life, it's important to be true to who you are while you do it. The next is know what you want before and after. When I was doing the National School Walkout, my mind was so focused on the date I had in mind, which was April 20th. Nothing else mattered. For the month I had building up to that, that was all that mattered, and I made sure that that day was the best I could make it. But I never really thought about what my ambitions were afterwards. And as I have a couple friends from my high school here, you can attest that after the walkout, I had no idea what to do with my life and what exactly I wanted to do. So in anything, make sure you know who you are, but also what you want before and after. And then also weigh the worst and best case scenario. We are all at any stages of our life trying something new. And it's really, really important to understand that even at your worst, you're still doing something new, and that can become your best. A lot of people, you did the National School Walkout, but they don't really know a lot of trials and tribulations that went coming beforehand. And I can tell you there were some worst case scenarios, but there was also some really wonderful things. So I wanted to talk about balance, which is not something I'm particularly good at, but I still wanted to talk about. This is a fancy little graph I found online. I don't know why that blocked out. I must have done something wrong with the slide. That's supposed to be, that's what you can be educated. So it's really complicated, but all I want to say is that I think you guys are doing your own campaigns, right? And so that's something you're obviously really passionate about, excited about. Well, it's really easy to get something that which you love, and that's something that the world needs. And that's, for me, that's the walkout. When I was advocating for common sense gun control, that was my main thing, is that this is something that I believe we need, but also the world needs. But there are two things that kind of went to the wayside when I was doing my work, and that was sure good, and that was you could be educated. I was a learning process for me, and I also have a lot of my studies go to the side. So, and whether it's doing something for Mr. President or anything as you get older, finding an activity or something you're passionate about that can hit all areas of the spectrum is super important. I think about, all of you go to school and all of you focus on your studies. Raise your hand if you do an activity after school. Right, so most of us. But you know it's important that to keep both of those as good as they can be. You want to have good grades, but you want to be good at whatever you do after school. And that's not something that applies to everything you do in life, whatever ambition it is. So that was one of the main tips that I really had to learn myself, which is, yes, the National School Walkout is my priority right now, but so is my friends, and so is my grades. Okay, this one is kind of funny to me. These are two photos of me speaking. First is at a rally in New York, another one during the National School Walkout. I am. And what I want to say is always write a speech, but then forget it. And what I mean by that is, whether you're doing campaign testing, whether you're speaking to kind of people about your new campaign, it's always really important to think about what you're going to say, but also being willing to adjust to the situation. And both of these, I have a speech clearly in my hand, but I'm not looking at it. Because in those moments, I felt that there was something more and something more urgent that I needed to say. And I think this is something that's really important to think about in any context in your life. If you are speaking to a friend, to a family member, you might be really determined on what you want to say, but feel free to switch it up and be really honest about who you are.
So basically, you write and speak, you don't really use it, and you talk about it, but if you don't know what to say, you can look at your speech and say it.
Exactly. I mean, everyone has a different style, but that's exactly right. Get your thoughts in order, but being able to adjust. A story I often tell is I was at a youth event in Chicago last summer, and I was speaking about gun violence. And right before I went on stage, there was a local representative from their Chicago gun violence chapter. She came from one of the most dangerous neighborhoods in Chicago. And she was talking to me about her personal experience, about, you know, having to be worried about getting to school, things that affected her brother and their community. And I was planning on speaking about my personal life, but also my road to change, and how I made this online petition, and how I do all these things. But she said to me a bunch of really important quotes that I found really inspiring. So my speech originally was just me talking a bit for 10 minutes, but I actually had her come up on stage and speak with me, because she had ideas that were so much more well-informed than I could ever be about the very city I was speaking in. So why would I not have her speak with me? So in any part of your life, be willing to adjust, and if that means changing how you balance, then you should. All right, and one last thing I want to talk about is I am, like I said, a junior at Richfield High School. I'm also a theater student. I was going to say major, but I'm not in college. And something I wanted to talk to all of you about is, and whether it's in politics and activism and science and art, the things you're passionate about are the things that are going to carry you the farthest. And as you guys get older, I know a lot of you are either in elementary school or middle school. Being committed to those things are what's most important. 2 years ago, I had no idea I'd be doing activism, but it's something I found that I'm good at, and it's something that I love. And so I guess what I want to end this with is, whatever you find really striking a chord with you, or carrying you, or really holding your heart, continue with that. And be willing to change things up. Because as I said, I was a theater student, auditioning for my school's musical was the most important thing to me. But now, it's doing this. So allow yourself to find new things and to change. And if you have any questions, feel free to raise your hand or ask me afterwards. But yeah, thank you.
We have a thank you gift for you too. Oh. The Miss President swag bag. And thank you. No, I love your tips, especially the write a speech and forget it. Which in fact is most compelling. And Hildy, we have a gift for you too. Please come up and accept our appreciation for all that you've done. Ms. Grob is also on our advisory board, and she has actually had a lot of influence on the whole program and each session of it. So thank you for all that you've always done. So, yeah. So, Lynn, the way it works is if we have the privilege of you coming back, where's Lynn go?